वेलकम टू रीबिल्ड माय चर्च अगेन RMCA बिशप चैनल। थैंक्स फॉर सब्सक्राइबिंग दिस चैनल एंड हियरिंग टू वीडियोस यस्टरडे एंड सेंडिंग देम टू योर गुड फ्रेंड्स। माय गॉड ब्लेस यू फॉर योर जेनरोसिटी एंड फॉर सपोर्टिंग मी इन दिस मिनिस्ट्री। इन द लास्ट टॉक नंबर 159 टाइटल्ड अ गिफ्ट दैट यू कैन गिव गॉड, we saw that what we are is by the grace of God and what we become is our gift to God. And from there today I would like to move to the next topic, at that which I thought will be very helpful for us to lead a very good, ordinary, happy, peaceful life. And I call that topic as pride. Pride is not only pointless, it is also factually misplaced. Therefore, getting rid of it is fundamental cornerstone of good life. So if we want to have a very good life, what is fundamentally to be done is to get rid of this concept or this reality or this sin which is called pride. What is pride? It is a feeling of deep pleasure or satisfaction derived from one's own achievements, the achievements of those with whom one is closely associated, or from qualities or possessions that widely admired. In other words, it can be a quality or a state of being proud, inordinate self-esteem, an unreasonable conceit of one's own superiority in talents, beauty, wealth, rank, etc., which manifests itself in lofty airs, distance, reserve, and often contempt of others. This is what is bad about it. Considering oneself superior to others and nursing a kind of contempt for other people. Nobody likes these type of people, precisely because of the contempt for others. In other words, it can be also said that the people who are proud are having disdainful behavior, treatment, insolence or arrogance of demeanor, haughty bearing and conduct, insolent exultation, etc. So putting together, we can say pride is an excessively high opinion of oneself. A proud man dies in his pride. They are called like tragic heroes. In Greek mythology and in Shakespearean writings, we come across such heroes. For example, Oedipus. When it comes to tragic heroes that follow Aristotle's model, Oedipus is your main man. Not only is he an influential king, but he is full of pride and self-righteousness. While he did kill his father and marry his mother, the ultimate choice that sent him down a road to tragedy was trying to change his fate. The fact that Oedipus was overall a good person and king makes him relatable to the audience, and they get sucked into his story. In the end, what happens? Oedipus dies, but not before a whole lot of suffering. Similarly, another tragic hero in the story of Romeo and Juliet by William Shakespeare. There, what do we find? When it comes to his tragic flaw of Romeo, it's his obsessive love of Juliet and his impatience. Rather than thinking something afoul might be at play, when he finds his poisoned wife, he just sucks down the poison himself, leading to his tragic demise. This is the end of proud people. They lose their reason and they are not able to look at the reality, but they go by their own thinking. Whatever they see they think is the reality and they go after that. That is why in the Proverb 16:18 we read, pride goes before destruction and a haughty spirit before stumbling. Therefore, what we need to avoid in our life is pride. And proud people are never grateful, you know. And grateful people are generally happier people, whereas proud people are not happy. That's why they speak highly of themselves, thinking that they will become happy by doing that, but it doesn't become. Especially Abdul Kalam, a former Indian president, has spoken about that in one occasion. He says, when you have a goal in life, don't look back till you reach there. Focus on your goal. But after reaching, he says, don't forget to look back. Pride will not allow you to look back and remember the people who helped you to reach that goal. They take full credit for themselves. That is what people don't like. So when we achieve something by God's grace, learn to look back and thank God and other people whom God sent to help us to reach that goal. That's why pride will not allow you to look back and to be grateful, and as a result, they can never be happy. Another important point what we notice in proud people is they use their own emotions as compass to navigate their life. They don't give any hoot to the feelings of other people. Pride gives importance to one's own emotions and not for others. And we should not do that. We should give importance to the feelings of other people. We proud people take their emotions seriously and not of others. But we should be people who take the emotions of others seriously rather than our own emotions. And therefore, if we want to be successful in life, what is and happy in life, joyful and lovable in life, we should not be proud people. Let us try to get rid of this sentiment of pride from our own lives. And I would like to throw a few light on this topic from the scriptures. In James 4:6, it is written, God opposes the proud but gives grace to the humble. This is a verse that we can remember. In Psalms chapter 10:4, we read, in the pride of his face the wicked does not him, and all his thoughts are, there is no God. So it is the proud man, he says, there is no God. Similarly, proud people will say, there is no need for the church. There is no need for priests. It is the proud people who are full of themselves speak like that. Romans 12:16 says, never be wise in your own sight. Never be wise in your own sight. If you consider yourself wise, that means there could be something wrong about it. In the letter of St. Paul to Galatians 6:3, if anyone thinks he is something when he is nothing, he deceives himself. So it is always better to think that we are nothing. All what we are by the grace of God. And that attitude will bring us lot of God's blessings. In Proverbs 27:2 gives a beautiful lesson. It says, let another praise you and not your own mouth, a stranger, and not your own lips, by your own lips. So let it be done by others. We don't need to boast. 2 Corinthians 10:17 says, let the one who boasts, boast in the Lord. And to conclude, in Luke 14:11, we read, Jesus says, For everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himself will be exalted. That's all, my dear, for today. Before I give my apostolic blessing to you, let me request you to forward this talk to others also for their benefit. Please listen to one more talk if possible. It will bring more God's blessings on you and on your family, in your work, etc. Now, please make an intention in your heart. You can make a prayer for an urgent need, and my blessing is to help you to receive that need. Okay? So here we go. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please keep me also in your prayers. Wish you a good day. Yours in the mission of the Church, Bishop Franco Molachelli.